Welcome back to the channel of the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're going to take a look at how we can gain some information on our Apache web server remotely using web server modules. As always, you can check on my web server, theurbanpenguin.com, to catch these videos, or follow me on Twitter or on Facebook. So of course we can use our Apache web server to gain information about its configuration, its current status. We can do this, but again you might choose not to. Certainly if we are going to enable it though, we're going to want some level of security. At the moment we'll just stick with our IP address, our host-based security, but we could also put user-based security, which we'll look at later. But in the first instance, we're going to be taking a look at how we can use modules to gain information and status of our server. So on my web server then, in the httpd.conf, we can take a look at the HTTP configuration. And we can see this is where we left it before. We had added in the extra modules to allow for host authentication and for the directory index with the mod dir. We need to add in some more modules. I suppose the way we would go is the more modules we put in, we might choose to put the modules in a separate configuration file. So if we put in the line include, and then generally we would put this in the extension directory conf.d and then modules.conf, or it could be fishandchips.conf, it doesn't matter, you choose the file name. I've already created this, so if we go back into our parent directory, so the server root is etc/httpd, so when we said conf.d it was in relationship to the server root, and we see we have the two modules that I had before, but I've put in the mod info and the mod status, so this is allow us to get the status and information from our server. Now of course just loading the modules is one thing, we're going to have to tell the modules to do something. So we put in some location directives, so we have a location directive for both the server status and server-info. So we'll put the server status in first, so location, server root, server-status, so the forward slash is just saying it's going to be at the root of the server. We close out our location with the forward slash location, and then we use set handler, and we're going to use server hyphen status, so this is where we're referencing the module, and we'll set up our security, so order, allow and deny. So with this we're going to allow only those people in the allow list, everyone else is denied, and in the allow list we're going to be a little bit more restrictive, we're just going to put one IP address. At the moment we're only restricting by the host module, we can also put user authentication if we want to tighten this up a little bit more. So with this in place we'll now create a new location for server info, so we can copy and paste these lines down. And instead of server status, it's going to be server info. So we access the server and then put in server-info and server status. And we'll have the same access control. We certainly need to be a little bit more secure on this, and you don't have to have these modules or this setup enabled. So with that set, we save the file. We can check our configuration with Apache control config test and then restart our service. Once it's restarted, we can check with our browser. So moving on to our client machine, we can see we can access the normal website and our hello welcome page. But if we change our URL then to forward slash, and we'll look at server hyphen status first, so server hyphen status, So we can see that we get information, so the date and time, how long the server's been up for. And if we scroll out, we can see at the bottom of the page, we can get more information with the extended status being on. So we've got basic information, but not too much information with server status at the moment. If we go back up to our URL and access the page server info, server info gives us a whole heap of information. So if we just look at the server info page and scroll our way down, there's lots of information. So compilation information, so when the software was compiled, what's using it, some memory locations, the modules, the configuration that's being used, even help and what directives are available to modules. So there's a huge amount of information that's available. We can access it all through the page here, or we can go up to the top of the page where they give us shortcut URLs through to the information. So if I go back up to the top of the page here, and if I click on configuration files, we can see we can even read the current configuration file. If we go back and look at the server settings, so we can get the version and the build date of the Apache server. We can look at the modules, so this is the same as our minus capital M on Apache control, our startup hooks, and then clicking on to even like the module information here, we can then go through, look at the information for different modules. Again, we can scroll down and we can see the other modules and the configuration for those modules. So heaps of information available, but let's check back on our server and see what extended information we can get through the server status. So if I go back into my configuration file and we'll add in the extended status on directive and value, and then take a look at the server status page to see how that differs. So once we've set that, we can check our configuration and we can use exclamation mark and then the starting letters to make a shortcut. So with this done, we return to our client browser and we can now view server status with the extended information. We get an additional line for each connection we currently have, and with a key to those columns just showing below. So certainly there's a lot of information that we can get both from server status and even more information from server info. So we certainly want to keep this secure, remembering I'm only allowing the single host access to this. So thank you very much, and I look forward to seeing you back soon.